All right, we're looking at C10 suspension today. So whether you have a stock crossmember or think about upgrading to a tubular crossmember, let's check out the differences. All right, guys, Dave Cass here with QA1. I'm here with
Jesse Westad.
And we're checking out different things with the C10 suspension. So we have a couple different systems for these trucks. So we have a 63 truck all the way up through 87. We have a coilover option for a stock crossmember, but also with a fully tubular crossmember from QA1. So we have two systems here, right? And they make a lot of big impacts to the truck. So Jesse, walk me through a couple of the things that are maybe a shared commonality between the two before we get into what's different about each one.
Yeah, both system is gonna give you that QA1 coilover. That's what we're really wanting here. We want that, that's the heart of it. That's the meat and potatoes. That thing is going to give you a couple of things. It's going to give us the ability to change our ride height, get, really dial in that stance that we're looking for. We're also going to be able to use the adjustability of the shock valving itself, whether it's a single adjustable shock, a double adjustable shock, all the way up to our mod shocks. We're going to be able to get not only the ride quality that you want, but for you performance guys, we're going to get you the handling that you need. The other similarity is going to be the control arm. It's going to shed some weight off the front of these, going to give you a little bit more modern geometry, going to add some caster into that. That's going to give you that feel of a more modern vehicle, give you that return to center that we all know and love from our modern cars and does not work out well for highway use in some of those older trucks.
All right, so let's start off by comparing both these kits. Now, I've had the privilege of running both systems on my own personal 72 truck. And really the heart and soul of the suspension is going to be the coilover system. Now, with a drop spindle, you can get this system right here with the stock crossmember, you can get that truck down 6 inches. Now, with the tubular crossmember, Jesse, what can you get with that?
With this one, what we're doing is we're actually using that crossmember to raise the suspension up on the frame in relation to it, and you can get a whole another 2 inches out of it.
Wow, 2 inches. And so on my truck, I've actually been able to lower the truck even more than what I did before. Now, you might find some considerations with that. You know, inner wheel tubs and stuff might become a limiting factor. There's some great products out there. Slosh tub is a really popular one that you can get a bigger inner wheel tub, get that full 8 inches out of the truck. So geometry is another thing though, right? So these trucks, you have to remember, we're talking 50, pushing 60 years old in some cases, and geometry back then is not what we expect today.
Not
so
at all.
Walk me through a little bit what you might find with this system right here, Jesse.
We're gonna give you a little bit more of a positive caster on this, which means that you're gonna get a little better feel driving down the highway, especially at modern freeway speeds, and that return to center is gonna feel a lot more solid and more familiar to you.
Absolutely, and one of the things that I really appreciated with it was that modern feel, right? But one of the things when you're working with the stock crossmember is we're limited in how much of that geometry can really shift. Whereas when we started doing the development on the fully tubular system, we're able to completely change where that wheel and tire sits. And so we addressed a very common thing with that, and that's putting the wheels back in the wheel well center, right? And I know with the larger wheel and tire, I run a 20-inch wheel on my truck, it was really nice putting that wheel back in the center.
And you can never go wrong by adding that rack and pinion into the system and really eliminating that old steering box slot.
Yes, yeah, that's a big one for sure. And a point of emphasis too, you know, with the stock crossmember, you have to remember, you have that steering box way on the outside of the frame rail, right? So it really limits your turning radius. You know, there are some aftermarket options out there for going to a quick ratio box, but still that big clunky box on the outside. So going to a rack and pinion was, you know, a really great option, really improves that driver feel. It's a later model box out of like a Dakota, so it's a modern rack and pinion, which was great. Plumbing is really easy and a great way to modernize that truck. All right, so that covers some really good improvements for the truck, but Jesse, what else do you get with the crossmember?
A big one is weight saving. We're knocking nearly 140 pounds off the front of these trucks, and we know they can all use that. A big one also is if you're doing a motor swap, it's a no-brainer. It comes with modular motor mounts. Do small block Chevys, big block Chevys, LS motors. We got DIY weld-in motor mounts so you can put whatever you can shoehorn into your truck.
Yeah, and I mean, even affecting the engine placement. On my truck, my engine sits a little bit lower, it sits back a little bit. So that DIY kit's a really great way to really put the engine wherever you want it.
So Dave, you were saying earlier that you got to experience these kits in various forms. Were you able to take that one and move into that easily?
Yeah, absolutely. So I was able to take basically everything you see right here, and I was able to move it over to the tubular system. So one of the things that we really spent some time designing into the system was the ability for someone to upgrade over time, right? So you might do that for two reasons. You might kind of build your truck in stages, a lot of us do. And so you don't want to have to repurchase parts that you've already purchased once before, right? So the tubular crossmember, we have what we call a retrofit kit. And so later down the road, if you don't want to buy everything at once, buy the crossmember, it comes with the rack and pinion, the various hardware that you need, but you take your existing control arms, the coilovers, the miscellaneous parts like that, it all adapts right to it. Pretty simple.
Very nice.
So there you have it. There's the key differences between the two QA1 systems we have for the C10 trucks. It's a great option, so you can build your truck in stages. You can do everything that you want to do from a street driver, pro touring truck, just have a ball with it. So more information on these, make sure to check out qa1.net/c10. Visit us on Facebook, more YouTube videos, whatever you might need.
As always, go drive it.